Factor common factors in grouping. Grouping with a change of order. Sometimes when we look and divide into our two groups, the binomials don't match. And if that happens, we need to change the order. Meaning we're going to rewrite these in a different order. So if I look at my first example here, divided into two groups, just like it is, I really don't have anything in common there. And it doesn't give me anything that's going to be in the second group. So I want to rewrite this. So one of the things that I tend to do is that I'll put my negatives together and put my positives together. So I'm going to move my 3AB over here and my 7 over here. The other thing that I want should keep in mind, it makes this go a little bit easier, is that if you start with a larger number, for example, if I have the 12a squared and I write the 3ab, when I go to do the second two, the 28a and the 7b, I want to start with my larger number there also. It will make sure that my numbers go in the same order and I get exactly the same in my binomial. So I'm going to write this as a negative 28a minus 7b. If I reverse that and put my 7b first, my numbers are going to be backwards. And sometimes that doesn't make a difference, but sometimes it does. This way it just ensures that they're always going to be in the same order. So divide that into two groups. 12 and 3 have a common factor of 3. And they both have an a in common, and my smallest exponent is an a, so I'm going to pull that out. 12 divided by 3 is 4. A squared divided by a is a. 3 divided by 3 is 1. A divided by a is 1. And that's going to leave me with a b. My last two terms both have a negative, so that means we're going to be factoring out a negative. And the only thing 7 and 28 have in common is a 7. So 28 divided by 7 is 4. We'll just have the a along. And 7 divided by 7 is 1. And it's because we're dividing by negative, it'll be positive. And that will leave me with a b. We now have 4a plus 1b. That's our common factor now. And make sure you put your parentheses for both. Those are gone, leaving me with 3a minus 7. Let's take a look at example 2. So if I just leave it the way it is, 6 and 20 have a common factor of 2. But the 8 and 15 have nothing in common. So I think I want to change my order here. I think that I'll bring the 8x over with my 6xy and bring my 20 over with my 15. So if I write this as a 6xy plus 8x, I'm going from smaller to larger. So 15 is smaller than 20. So I'm going to write my 15 first minus 20. All right, break this into two groups. Now 6 and 8 have a common factor of 2, and we also have a common factor of the x. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. X divided by x is 1, that leaves me with just the y. 8 divided by 2 is 4. X divided by x is 1, so it'll just be a 4. Both my last terms have a negative, so that means I'm going to be factoring out a negative. 15 and 20 have a common factor of 5. 15 divided by 5 is 3, and leaves with a y. And 20 divided by 5 is going to be 4. So I now have a binomial common factor of 3y plus 4. just want to write that down. Those are gone now. And it leaves me with the 2x minus 5. I have now completely factored that.